Okay, let's get up and running with Redwood. If you're new to the Self-Teach Me channel, my name is Amy Dutton. I'm a web designer and developer. I want to help you level up and get to where you want to be. So if this sounds interesting to you, hit the subscribe button below. Now, real quick, before we jump into it, I've included chapter marks within the description below if you want to jump around to the part that you need. Okay, so let's start by pulling up the RedwoodJS documentation, and I'll include a link in the description below. So if we click on this quick start link in the sidebar, we should get all the information we need to be able to get our project up and running. So you'll notice we need Node 18 and Yarn version greater than 1.15. So the easiest way to get up and running with Node is to go to the Node.js website. However, you'll notice that the latest version of Node that they have you download is version 20, and we need version 18. So you can still run Redwood with version 20, but it will give you a warning when you first install. So my preference and recommendation is to use NVM instead. NVM stands for Node Version Manager and allows you to install multiple versions of Node on your computer. If you take a look at the documentation, you can run this curl script, just copy and paste it into your terminal. Then you should be able to use NVM. If you want to make sure that it's running properly, in the terminal, run NVM-V and it will tell you what version of NVM you're running. Otherwise, it will say command not found. Now, you should be able to say NVM install v18.16.0, and then you can use it by saying NVM use v18.16.0 to actually use it. Now, you can also say to set the default version of Node to version 18.16, NVM alias default v18.16.0. Cool. Now for Yarn, this is even easier. If we click on the Get Started link at the top of their page and then installation in the sidebar, you'll see that the best way to manage Yarn is through a project called CorePack. And conveniently, CorePack ships with Node.js. All we need to do is enable CorePack if it isn't already enabled. So you can just say CorePack enable within the terminal. Simple, right? Now that we have all of our dependencies in place, let's create our Redwood project. So in the terminal, and this is the terminal warp, and I'll include a link in the description below. Hyper and iTerm are two other great alternatives. And when we start writing code, I'll be inside VS Code, which also has a dedicated terminal. So any of these terminals will get the job done. So going back to the Redwood docs, we can just copy and paste this line into the terminal. Yarn create Redwood app, my Redwood project. And notice I'm already in my sites directory, which is where I want my project to live. So here it's suggesting that we name our project my Redwood project. And I'm going to change this to Brazilian Nut News __RW. And I just like to tack the framework that I'm using on at the end. This is purely just personal preference. So Redwood will ask a few questions and we can work through the prompts, and then it will install all the dependencies that we need. Before we run Yarn Redwood Dev, I want to set up our database. And with Redwood, we can use SQLite or Postgres. My personal preference is Postgres. And you can install Postgres locally on your computer, but I'm going to keep it easy peasy and reach for Supabase instead. So if you decide you'd rather set up Postgres, I'll include a link in the description to point you in the right direction. But I'm a big fan of Supabase. It's free to set up an account. Plus, it will give you a nice user interface to see the data that you're working with. So once your database has been initialized, you can go to the project settings or the gear icon on the left side and then click on database. And in the connection string section, click on URI. Let's copy that to our clipboard. Okay, I'm gonna jump over to the terminal and run code period, which will open our project within VS Code, which is my editor of choice. Now inside the .env file, I'm going to uncomment the database __URL and paste in the URL that Supabase provide us with. We'll also need to swap out the password with our actual database password. Now within the terminal, you should be able to run yarn install, and this will grab all of the project dependencies. Then you can run yarn redwood dev, and you should be able to see the Redwood splash screen. Congratulations! Now that we've done all the hard work, I will share a little shortcut with you if you don't want to mess with this entire setup. You can always launch Redwood inside of Gitpod. Now Gitpod is an online coding environment similar to Code Spaces or StackBlitz if you are familiar with those companies. In the description below, you'll find a link to this project on GitHub. It includes a separate folder for each lesson with that lesson's finished code. But Maybe, or more importantly, there are links to launch each lesson inside of Gitpod. Once the project is open in Gitpod, you have access to a ports panel where you can view the front end, that Redwood splash screen that we already saw, as well as the backend API layer. You can also click on the Gitpod button in the bottom left to launch the code within VS Code on your computer. And it will probably prompt you to install a few extensions, but it is a very handy option. A few last minute housekeeping things that always seem to come up. As you may have noticed, I'm using VS Code, which seems to be the current industry standard. I'm using the Cobalt 2 theme and the font is Dank Mono. It's a paid font, but it's not a ton of money and it has some great ligatures built in for writing code. So for example, typing equals greater than turns into an actual arrow. But if you're tight for cash, Fero Mono is another personal favorite and it has all the ligature bells and whistles and it's free. Now I have a bunch of plugins and extensions that I'm using within VS Code. I've written an entire blog post on Hashnode and will include a link in the description below if you want to check that out. If you see me writing code and hit save and things automatically reorganize and straighten up, I'm using ESLint and Prettier. I highly recommend both of those for coding consistency. Plus, it means you don't have to worry about tabs, spaces, single quotes, double quotes, semicolons, and all the things. The editor just takes care of it all for you. Plus, Redwood has a built-in configuration, so you don't have to do anything. But I did want to point it out just in case you see code moving around. Don't be alarmed. Now, last but certainly not least, Chrome is my browser of choice. I do have an extension for React Developer Tools and Apollo Developer Tools. Like always, I'll include links to both of those within the description below. As a quick recap, in this video, we installed Node, Yarn, and created our RedwoodJS project. We got our database up and running on Supabase, and then we took a brief look at Gitpod and discussed a few other tools to make our developer experience silky smooth. In the next video, we'll discuss the Redwood folder structure and some of the opinions that make Redwood Redwood and make it a true full stack framework. Be sure to hit the subscribe button below and click on the bell icon so you get notifications when new videos are posted. I'll catch you there. I'm ridiculous. Okay. Mm-hmm.